Hey there, and thanks for stopping by. My name is Bradley Knapp, and I'm one of the product managers here at IBM Cloud. And the question that we're going to answer today is, what is the difference between DevOps and SRE? This is a question that I hear on a fairly regular basis, not just internally, but from external customers as well. And it's one that we'd like to help you walk through so that you can really figure out what makes sense in your organization. And I think the answer is probably going to surprise you a little bit. Before we get into the video, I do want to encourage you to like and subscribe if you think that you're going to enjoy these things. Just click on those buttons. That way you get notified every time we come out with something new. So with that, let's get right into the question. And the question is, DevOps versus SRE. And so as we get into this, I think probably the most important thing to understand is this isn't a versus question. You don't have to have one or the other. As a matter of fact, I would argue, and I think that many people would agree, that SRE is actually an essential component of DevOps. And DevOps, a good properly implemented DevOps method, leads to the necessity of SRE when it comes time to deploy. They're two sides of the same coin. And so that's obviously going to lead to a little bit of confusion because DevOps is the development methodology, right? It's all about integrating your development teams and your operations teams. It's about knocking down those silos between them. It's about ensuring that everybody is singing off the same songbook. And that's very important. And SRE is in charge of automating all of the things and making sure that you never go down. There are really two parts of the same group. And so let's look at the differences, right? Because they do have some differences. Probably the first and largest one is that when we think about our DevOps side over here, right? DevOps is about core development. The DevOps guys, particularly your developers, they are doing the core development. They are answering the question, what do we want to do? They are working with product, they're working with sales, they're working with marketing to develop, design, and deploy. What is it that we do? They're working on the core. SRE, on the other hand, they're not working on the core. What they are working is the implementation of the core. They are working on the deployment. And they are constantly giving feedback back into that core development group to say, hey, something that you guys have designed isn't working exactly the way that you think that it is. So if we were to break that down a little bit more, they are helping the DevOps group, our SRE group, is helping the DevOps group to break down even more of those silos. If you want to think about it this way, DevOps is trying to develop the answer to how do we solve this problem? SRE is saying, how do we deploy and maintain and run to solve this problem? It's the theoretical versus the practical. And ideally, they're talking to each other every day, right? Because SRE should be logging defects. They should be logging tickets back with development. But probably most importantly, they need to understand that they have the same goals. These groups should never be aligned against one another. And so they do have to have a common understanding. Let's talk about one of the most important parts, right? We're going to talk about failure. Because failure is not necessary. Failure is just a way of life. It doesn't matter what you deploy. It doesn't matter how well it goes. It's going to happen. And so when we talk about failure, everyone involved needs to understand that there's going to be some level, right? There is a failure budget or an error budget where things are going to go wrong. And what happens when things go wrong, that's what figures out whether or not your organization is working. Because your SRE team, when it comes to failure, they're going to anticipate it, they're going to monitor it, they're going to log it, they're going to record everything. And ideally, they can identify a failure before it happens. They're going to have predictive analytics that are going to say, all right, this thing is going to go bad based on what we've seen before. And so SRE is responsible for mitigating some of those failures through monitoring and logging and doing the preemptive part, right? So we'll do the monitors, we'll do the logs. SRE is also going to lead all of your post-actual failure incident management, right? They're going to get you through the incident to begin with, and then they're going to hot wash it when it's done. They're going to lead that RCA, that root cause analysis. And after they have that RCA completed, and this is the most important part, they have to take that RCA data and bring it back over into dev and get some tickets open. You have to get dev online because you've got to, these are the guys who are going to solve the core problem. Some RCAs might be solved by SRE internally, right? They're going to spend 50% of their time writing, 50% of their time working. And so some of that problem, they may be able to fix directly. But sometimes that's not the case, right? Our RCA may have found a problem that only dev can fix. And that's all right. That's not a big deal. They're going to get that over here. Dev is going to implement, and then probably the most important part, right? So you're going to get that new feature. Dev is going to get that pulled together. They're going to get that new feature rolled out, and then they're going to pass that back into SRE, and they're going to say, hey, SRE, that problem that we had, we got a new feature for you. And then our guys on the SRE side, what do? They then have to take that feature and they have to figure out how to integrate it into their monitoring and their logging efforts to make sure that we don't get into another RCA for the same kind of a problem. So these groups, they are part and parcel of the same bunch. You really can't have one successful organization without another. And when it comes to figuring out a distinction, it's not something that you should spend a lot of time with. They are different skill sets, right? Core development, DevOps, these are the guys that really love writing software. SRE is a little bit more of an investigative mindset, right? You have to be willing to go out and do that analysis, figure out what things have gone wrong, automate all of the things. But there's a lot that they have in common. Everyone should be writing automation. Everyone should be getting rid of toil as much as possible because we just don't have the time to be doing manual tasks when we can put the computers in charge of it, right? Computers are not great at thinking on their own, but if you need it to do the same thing over and over and over again in exactly the same way, you can't beat computing for that. And so automation is key. You just have a slightly different mindset. DevOps is going to automate deployment. They're going to automate tasks. They're going to automate feature. SRE is going to automate redundancy, and they're going to automate manual tasks that they can turn into programmatic tasks to keep the stack up. And so, you know, when we talk about DevOps versus SRE, that's not the question. The question is, how do we build DevOps? How do we build SRE? And how do we be sure that they are always talking to each other? Because the institutional knowledge that SRE has so much of, if that doesn't get passed back into your DevOps group, you're never going to be successful. You're going to have a silo here and a silo here. And at the end of the day, both of these philosophies, core component, is getting rid of silos. Freeing ourselves from those silos is what is going to make us all more successful. Thank you so much for stopping by the channel today. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to share them with us below. If you enjoyed this video and you would like to see more like it in the future, please do like the video and subscribe to us so that we'll know to keep creating for you.